Welcome to this Stateless Code video. This is video number 6 in our series, Enough Inkscape to be Dangerous. So similar to our last video, in this video we'll be making a logo for a video series. So if I go and want transparent Inkscape here, I just need to pictures. We'll start with our transparent logo and ideally the screen doesn't freeze up. All right, we're back. Let's take a look at our layers, make sure that our So, let's select everything. Actually, I'll while I'm in here, and this is going to be something I'll wind up having to pause and go through all my assets and change, I want these angle brackets to be a little bit bigger. So let's deselect. I want just you. So right now, height and width 18 and 15. See what happens when I move this up to 17.415. All right, now I need to adjust the X coordinate on this slightly. That's fine. This one is kind of like 78. That's too far. Split the difference. Go, and then this one probably want to move close to 10. There. I think I like that better. Yep, I'm going to do that. So I'll pause and apply that to all of my assets everywhere, which is going to take a while, and then I'll come back and continue working on the WordPress logo. Oh, before we do that, let's select everything, move it all to one layer, and group it. Select all in all layers. And then I want to move selection to layer 1. And then I want to group the selected objects. And we'll save. And then the tedious job of going through and fixing everything. So we can see in the overlay on this slide here that I'm replacing the variance between the two logos. So it's a little bit narrower, and the anarchy symbol moves slightly, but that's kind of what we got. So another thing to note, so I'm working on the logo right now. The background, I've noticed, because the opacity is only 63 here, and when you put it on light backgrounds, the logo looks lighter. When you put the logo on dark backgrounds, the background looks darker. So rather than having the opacity vary like that, I'm going to get it full here, and then in order to get it closer to where it was before, I'm going to modify the lightness of the gradient points instead of relying on opacity to solve that problem. It'll get a more consistent display of the logo. So that was a really difficult thing to find. So if you click here, edit gradient is where you can get the breakpoints on this. So it is not the color here. Get back to the opacity. That's going to be 100. And then we've got our breakpoints here. That's not 53 though. Back to this. I want to So maybe we'll bump this up to maybe 50. That got weird. I need a lower saturation on the other side. So I'll bring this up to 88 maybe. Bring this side down to 25. Or actually we were bringing it up. Oops. This one. Oh. To 40. Move the saturation down. Farther. That's about where we had it. Maybe a little bit darker up here. There. I think that's what we want. So we'll save that. We'll do the save as. And we'll continue. Note if anything else interesting comes up. So, in all the fuss over the gradient background, I never actually imported the logo, so that's an important thing to do on each of these. All right, there we go. So we've got our newer version of the logo there. Continue on. So, anyway, I now have... up to an even 100. That might be too big. No, I think that's about right. We've got the nerdy die, and then I want to do a nerdy die red. So now I'm going to want to cut our layers. We'll lock this, and then our die. So I'm going to temporarily ungroup here. And then deselect. Die if I can. Move you to the die. Hide the glasses. And then see if I can ungroup select. So 20, so we can change the color here. It's not font anymore, so it's an object. That's going to be, call it pretty good. So I'll stop and do that with all the other numbers and get it changed. All right, so I've got the numbers changed. Now I need to get the triangles changed. And I've got all the triangles changed. Now I should be able to go back to layers. Unhide the glasses. Rename the layer. Oh, we have one. Somehow the dot of the 6 is still see if I can zoom in on it. There we go. I was able to get it. Oh, and all of these borders are still green slightly. So that's something I need to address. So it's on the stroke paint here. So for all of these, let's make them a little bit darker. I think I'll go through and apply that to all the triangles again. There, now I think we've got our red nerdy die. All right, so the next part of what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into this nerdy die, and I've got the glasses I want to move up slightly. So we're going to go edit, going to so that's what we want, lock these. You and let's try 29. 28.694 is what I want. Copy that. Now I'll go back and unlock all of these. Select all. Actually, I don't need to. This isn't. I won't group these quite yet. Let me hold off on doing that. So do that. Do the same thing with the. So we'll close and I'll show the difference between what we had before and what we have now. So this is the red. You can see it's much lower. I think the getting it a little bit higher, just slightly off of the 20, is what we want. So do the same thing with the red. And glasses. That's what I want. Unlock those. Lock everything else temporarily. Get the glasses. Modify the Y. That is not what I wanted. I think it was 28. Yeah, that gives me what I want. So, got that. All right, so I think I've tracked down all my SVGs and updated them. I'm just gonna give one example of a conversion here. So, exit out of here and I will launch GIMP and then from GIMP open one of these. In this case I'll go with one of the wallpapers here, pictures, and then wallpaper. So our standard wallpaper, we will. We actually have to import. No, it's there. Standard wallpaper. So it's called exit wallpaper currently. So open that. The 3840. Load it. Export as. This would be standard wallpaper. 4K. Place it. Export it. Go to that file, this is our standard wallpaper loaded up. And now it's got the closer version of the characters there, the slightly bigger angle brackets, and we'll apply that to everything else. So I had initially thought about making this episode about designing the logo for the statelesscode.com WordPress. We'll pick that up in the next episode. So this kind of turned into I'm going to slightly alter the Stateless Code logo and then change it everywhere. And so I got a bit sidetracked. So back next time, I will do what I said I was going to do in the introduction to this video and create the WordPress, Stateless Code WordPress logo. Thanks for watching this Stateless Code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels. Follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.